Ohm's law applied to neuro and cardiophysiology. From physics, we know that voltage equals flow times resistance, or V equals IR. Voltage means difference. In an electrical battery, there is a difference in charge. Let's say one side of the battery has 20 electrons and the other side has 600 electrons. If you connect the two sides with a wire, the electrons will flow down the gradient until each side is equal at 310 electrons. You can also put a light bulb in the wire, so as the electrons flow through the bulb, it gives off light. If there are more electrons on one side, thus a greater voltage, the electrons will flow faster, giving off more light. If there is more resistance, because the wire is rough and less conductive, the electrons will struggle to flow down the wire. This slow flow of electrons means that the battery will last longer, but the bulb won't glow as brightly. This electrical concept also applies to biology. Humans aren't made of batteries and wires, but we do have charge gradients and channels. Instead of electrons, there are sodium ions, 20 inside and 600 outside. And instead of a wire, channels connect the two sides. When you open the channels, the sodium flows into the cell. If you increase the voltage or ion gradient, the ions will flow more quickly. If you increase resistance by blocking channels with an antagonist, the signal will be conducted more slowly. Ohm's law doesn't just apply to electrical systems. The heart muscle also has a voltage or difference. Instead of electricity, it has a pressure differential. When the heart contracts, there is a lot of pressure. When it relaxes, there is less pressure. Instead of electrons flowing, there are blood cells that flow, not through a wire, but through arteries. When the heart squeezes harder, like during exercise, voltage increases, making blood flow more quickly. Clogging arteries with fat creates more resistance, so if your heart has the same pressure difference, blood flow is slower. To maintain the correct blood supply, your heart contracts with greater force, increasing the voltage to overcome this increased resistance. This is much more work for your heart, contracting this hard every second of every day, which is why blocking your arteries with fat leads to a heart attack. So, eat less French fries and you'll live longer. Help Hippo, better than learning from Wikipedia.